Hello and welcome to part 2 of this Illustrator guide with Avikash. In this guide, we will learn to trace any pixel art image to vector so we can modify and color them freely. By the end of this tutorial, we will trace and color the rabbit shown below. Few important tips I should highlight before we move on. Press Alt plus mouse wheel in and out to zoom and hold down space and move your mouse to move your image like so. So zoom in, zoom out while holding Alt and holding space, I can move the image. I should move these tips somewhere here for reference. Anyways, so let's just download any non-copyright easy to trace image from Google search by searching the image, right clicking on the image and save your image as, and the image will be downloaded in your downloads folder, I believe. Now from your download folder, drag the image into your Adobe Illustrator. Not this image, hold on. I believe this is the rabbit image we just downloaded. So we drag this image into Illustrator and we can just select and move this rabbit aside a bit, and with the black arrow direct selection selection tool, we select the rabbit, hold down the shift key and make rabbit bigger proportionally. If you don't hold on the shift key, then the rabbit will be distorted. We just do Control plus Z to undo that. Let me just zoom in by using Alt plus mouse wheel to show indeed this is a pixel art image while this is traced to a vector image, for that ultimate clarity we discussed on the first video. Anyways, so just select this image and then come up to the object menu and go to trace image and to make. So the image has been indeed traced to vector, however it is traced with white background, so it's hard to do color and it's also in a group, so we cannot do anything with it. So what we need to do is on this quick options panel, we see our image tracing options here. We click it and a whole lot of image tracing options comes about, and if it's not expanded, we expand the advanced setting, and then what we do is for example, just put this image, see the white background on the image, we go ignore white, and then now the image is traced with the borders only. Let's move it back up here and everything is looks all right. We can just adjust these bars to see the preview if we need it be. For now the image is traced cleanly. So what we do is close this options panel and then we expand the image. So everything is expanded, then we select our direct selection tool and then we highlight the extra borders, we don't need those from here, and we just click delete on the keyboard. Sorry about that. So we zoom in further to the image and it's been traced perfectly. Now all we do is we can modify or color the image. If with the direct selection tool, we can select any part and click delete. If we don't, Control Z, if we don't need that part. And to color the image, we just select the part we need to color. For example, we have just selected this circle over here and let's fill it with gray, and then we select this big circle. We can also pick color from the previous image or anything from the artwork. There is a color picker tool, it's called eyedropper tool. We select that and we pick color from anywhere we like. We pick it from here and just like that, with the direct selection tool, we select whatever we need. We very careful while selecting the border or the image. We just need to select the interior of the image, and we can put any color we want. We can go interior of the two, select, and so I'm just gonna pause the video and complete the image now to save time. So once we done with the image, we can use our black arrow to move it. Hold down shift to resize. If you don't hold down shift, we can deform. Also with the we control Z here, and we can just put the direct selection tool over the image, select it, hold down alt, and you see a double arrow. If we leave alt, no double arrow. If we hold down alt and we get a double arrow, we can make a copy of the image, and we can just resize the image and then hold alt and make copy of the image, and so on and so forth. Anyways, this concludes this video tutorial. I'll see you guys in the next one. Okay, make sure to like my channel and subscribe. Thank you.